Hey guys, Wet Movie One back here again, and it's time to go hoard up. Are you guys ready? I know I sure am. Halloween 2018 hits Blu-ray and 4K today. Even gets a Best Buy exclusive steelbook out there, along with I believe Goosebumps 2 hits Blu-ray and stuff today, which I'm kind of interested in seeing. Kind of like the first one that came out, with Jack Black. And I also believe Once Upon a Deadpool, Deadpool 2 or Deadpool Different Cut, PG-13 cut, comes out today on Blu-ray and things. But I'm going to be heading on out, going to the usual spots. So come along with me and make sure you also stay tuned to the end of this video for some DVD and Blu-ray reviews. Alright guys, at my first destination of the day, the local Best Buy. Let's head on in and see if they have those Halloween steelbooks, which I don't know if I'm going to get because I already own the 4K already, but I just kind of want to see it in person, you know what I'm saying? Alright guys, in Best Buy right now at the new release rack over here. The first thing I see is Once Upon a Deadpool, the new one with Fred Savage. It's like, of course, the PG-13 cut of Deadpool 2, which I'm down to check out sooner or later, but I'm not gonna lie, have to sit down and watch Deadpool 2. Haven't watched the version I have yet. And the other thing that came out today on Blu-ray and 4K is that new Goosebumps movie, which looks like it could be a lot of fun. You know what I mean? The first one was. I really did enjoy that, but what I enjoy more was watching the old Goosebumps, TV specials or TV show from back in the 90s or whatever. Those were kind of cool, like the Haunted Mask and stuff like that. That stuff was sick to me, you know, back in the day. But that's all I'm really seeing on this side. I'm gonna go to the movie section itself and see what they got going. Because, yeah, guys, when I was up at the front, I saw Halloween, but I didn't see any Halloween, you know, Best Buy exclusive steelbooks. So they may be sold out of them already, and it's only 1 o'clock in the afternoon. All right, now I'm in the section itself over here, and I'm not really seeing anything else really different than they had up front, you know, like the Deadpool 2, but they do have, like, the Halloween Blu-ray and 4K over here. This is the edition right here I already have, you know, at home that I talked about in my, last hoarding up video or... I did it like on Blu-ray, on DVD, and you know, an unboxing video, whatever, of this bad boy a few weeks ago. I have a link for it in the description box if you guys want to check out my unboxing video and review of the new Halloween movie in the description box of this video. Well, guys, getting out of Best Buy right now. Sad to say, they sold out of those Halloween, 4K steelbooks up in there, which I thought they might have still had some left, you know, since it's only like 1 o'clock or so in the afternoon. But hey. It's okay, I'm glad I already got the one I got. And let me know if any of you guys picked up the steelbook today. All right, everyone, at my next destination of the day, the local Target. Let's head up in there and see what kind of cool stuff they have going on. And before I get in there, I wanted to let you guys all know, I may or may not be having a new Hoarding Up video next week, because next Tuesday, I have this movie premiere I was invited to in Hollywood, which may turn out to be really super cool. So stay tuned for that video. But yeah, I just want to say, Hoarding Up video next week may or may not happen. But I'm gonna do my best to do it if I can. Well guys, in Target right now, just roaming around, seeing if there's any good deals there are to be had. But I'm not really seeing, much of anything that's good deals or anything. And the only thing I saw that wasn't at Best Buy that is a movie called The Old Man and the Gun. Starring, what's his name again, Robert Redford. Other than that's all the same old stuff. They didn't even have Halloween out over here today. Either that or they sold out of them or what have you. But they do have the Deadpool 2, Once Upon a Deadpool Blu-ray up there, along with like a little toy and everything over here. But this is the only thing different. But guys, I honestly want to know, how many of you out there are actually going to be buying this one right here, the PG-13 version of, Deadpool 2? And if any of you guys ever seen it, and is it worth getting? Because I do love me some Fred Savage, of course, from like back in the day, the Wonder Years and things. But let me know down below, is this worth getting or is this just a cash grab? Well, guys, getting out of Target now, that was kind of a bust. Like I said a couple seconds ago, they didn't even get the Halloweens in there today. And plus, I don't even think there was any exclusives for Target. It was just the Best Buy Steelbook this week for Halloween. But I'm glad I got my 4K of that. Hopefully I get it signed soon by some of the casting people from that movie at Monsterpalooza this year. All right, everyone, at my last stop of the day, the local Walmart. Let's head on in there, get out of the rain. Well, guys, just got into Walmart right here, and I see this. This might have came out this week or the week before, The Purge Season 1. Have any of you guys seen this before? Because I kind of dig the Purge movies, but I never knew there was a TV show, and it looks like it came out on the USA Network.
Have any of you guys seen this? And if you did, let me know. Is this worth getting? But of course, Walmart has, you know, the Goosebumps 2 DVD, and of course, you know, Blu-ray up here, along with Once Upon a Deadpool. And no exclusives for the Halloween over here. This seems like the regular, you know, standard edition. Not even like different artwork or anything. Nothing really new or different. But like new release wise, that's kind of strange. And they have like romantic comedies and 80s movies down here. Wait, what's going on with the movie section over here today? But guys, some of the other movies that Walmart has today is a John Travolta flick called Speed Kills. Looks like some sort of weird Speed 2 ripoff, because if you remember, Speed 2 took place on a boat and everything, but I don't know exactly, you know, what this one is, but I do like John Travolta. He's cool. They do have that Old Man and a Gun up over here, and some movie, looks like it's from A24 or Lionsgate or something called Jonathan, which I don't know anything about, but like I said, let me know down below if it's worth watching. Well, guys, I got out of the movie section right now over here in the, you know, the dairy area to get some milk for the house. But I was looking at the Goosebumps 2 today, and is Jack Black not in part 2? You know what I mean? I know Jack Black was in the first one. Is he not in this new one, and Ken Jeong took his place or something? Because I'm looking at the cover and the back, and I don't see his name anywhere. Well, guys, all I'm really going to be getting today is 2 jugs of milk to bring on home. So now, guys, let's get on home for some DVD and Blu-ray reviews. All right, everyone, now on to the review portion of this video here. I have a small stack of DVDs, Blu-rays to talk to you guys about today, so let's get started with it. The first one up I got sent for free to review from Warner Brothers Home Entertainment, and that is the complete third season of Fuller House here on DVD. I know the show is a Netflix original show, and it's, of course, based off the Full House TV show that I watched when I was a kid growing up. And you can watch it, of course, on HD on Netflix. But this is the only way you can get it on physical media is DVD only, you know, through, you know, Warner Brothers. And I just had to get my hands on it. I have the other 2 seasons of it, you know, on DVD that they put out. Of course, you get all the episodes from season 3 in here. And in this season, they kind of, you know, it still follows, you know, Kimmy, Stephanie and DJ, you know, living in the same house that, you know, they pretty much lived in when in the original series, and, you know, dealing with their, you know, daily, you know, family issues and things. And now Fernando, Kimmy's husband, has moved in to the Gibbler home next door where Kimmy, you know, lived before, and is having like a weird thing with Kimmy. And you know, like they're having like sort of like relationship problems. Kimmy doesn't really want to see him that often, but he comes over all the time anyway. And of course, DJ Tanner in the show is a veterinarian and is trying to get her son now in, trying to become a doctor, at a little pet hospital. I still like this show. You get your, you know, your obligatory cameos from Bob Saget, David Coulier, and John Stamos, you know, sporadically throughout the, you know, the season here. I still think this show's a lot of fun. It still, you know, brings back the memories as it did for me, you know, watching the older show on television. I still like the chemistry between, you know, the girls here, you know, the main three, and it's kind of cool. Like, I really like Andrea Barber. You know what I mean? Like, I started to really like her a lot more since I started following her on YouTube. She makes, like, you know, vlogs and stuff, and sometimes she makes vlogs on the set of Full House or Fuller House. And, I don't know, I just think she's a really cool, you know, person or personality, and hopefully one day I get to meet her. She just seems pretty damn cool. But I just want to let you guys know that she has a YouTube channel, and that season 3 is out now on DVD. So if any of you guys are interested, make sure you guys check out your local stores. And the next 2 up over here I got from Scream Factory, also known as Shout Factory. And this is the first film right here. Is a film I think I've seen once before, a long time ago, like on VHS or maybe DVD. And it's a film directed by Tobe Hooper, the director of the original Texas Chainsaw Massacre. And it's based off a Stephen King short film. And it stars Freddy Krueger himself, Robert Englund, and that is the Mangler. This one right here is pretty much takes place at this little laundry factory where a whole bunch of women and stuff are you know, are dealing with this one big giant, you know, like Jurassic kind of machine, old machine, and they're like, you know, using it to fold laundry and different things, and, you know, to do their job. But yet this machine has a taste for blood and has killed, you know, women before by accident, supposedly. And now there's this cop or detective that's on the case trying to figure out, you know, what's going on, because the guy that's running
the laundry is Robert Englund, and he's kind of like a weird, strange dude. He looks like he doesn't really have any legs, and something may have happened to him before. But yet he's kind of a weird guy, and he's just trying to figure out what's going on because the ladies are going back to work, and something else happens again. Something happens with that machine yet again, and it's just like a series of events that happen at this laundry, and you have to, you know, come to find out what happens. I found this one to be actually really kind of cool, really entertaining, and it looks really nice here on Blu-ray. They have a 2K scan from the original camera negative, and you also get the unrated cut of the film on here. I don't know if I remember, you know, like watching the theatrical or unrated back in the day or anything, but like this movie was really cool. You get an audio commentary track by one of the co-writers, and a new interview in here by Robert Englund. That's like, what, 20-something minutes long of him talking about the making of this film and how he enjoyed playing this character, of this laundromat, of this manager of this, you know, laundromat kind of thing, or owner or whatever. I thought this was a really fun movie. Cheesy, of course, but I think all your horror fans, if you've never seen it before, would really get a kick out of this one. And next up over here is a film directed by Joel Schumacher. And it's a movie that I've watched once a long, long time ago, kind of like The Mangler, like back on the day when it first came out to DVD. And it's the first time watching it since then. And I'm like, this movie is actually a lot better than I remembered. And it stars Nicolas Cage, and it's 8mm for the first time here on Blu-ray from Scream Factory, you know, with like all new special features and things. But it's pretty much about this detective who's hired by this old, really wealthy lady to find out what's on this, you know, old film that she found, you know, in her husband's, you know, things. Her husband, you know, this old lady's husband passed away or whatever. And she found this film of this young girl getting killed, like a snuff film. And she wants to find, you know, this old lady wants to find out, is this girl still alive? Who produced this? And why the hell is this in my house? And Nicolas Cage is the detective that, you know, goes on this journey to find out, what, you know, is this girl still alive, and who made this tape, and try to unfold the madness, which is the snuff film. And this movie was just really creepy, really well, you know, put together. I really did enjoy this one, man. It was like really tense, thrilling, just a really good watch. And on this Blu-ray here, we get a new interview in here by Joel Schumacher. Just him sitting there talking face-to-face with us, you know, on camera, talking about his experience making the movie, and how a lot of studios didn't want to make this film because of the subject matter, and all sorts of stuff that he talked about in here. And of course, you get audio commentary track by with him, theatrical trailer, TV spots. I know they made a sequel to this, and I kind of want to watch it now, but I'm sure it's probably not as good, you know, as this one. But 8mm, definitely check it out if you guys have never seen it before, and if you like Nicolas Cage, I'm sure you guys would like this one right here. And this next one up right here, I was kind of dreading talking about this one. This one stars Dakota Johnson, and it's put out by Lionsgate Home Entertainment. And that is the remake of Suspiria here. Of course, it's a remake from the 1970s, or I know it was the original one came out in the 70s sometime, directed by Dario Argento. And this is, of course, the new version of it. It's not exactly a remake, but it is a remake. It's pretty much about this young girl that attends this, you know, dance academy, and kind of slowly finds out that she may or may not be part of a cult, you know, that's part of this dance troupe, and all the craziness that, you know, happens from there. But I can't lie, okay? I love horror movies and everything, but there's just some that I just can't get into very much. The original Suspiria looks fantastic, but it bores me. I just can't get into it. And it was the same case with this one. Good acting in here, but just like the pacing of it, and it's just not my style. I really thought I was going to get into this one. I thought I was going to be a little bit more Hollywooded up a little bit. You know what I mean? Compared to the Dario Argento one. Don't get me wrong. I appreciate Dario Argento's, you know, touch when it comes to films, but just certain things, certain movies, I have a hard time getting into, like the whole pacing of things, and I don't know, it was just kind of, I kind of fell asleep watching this and kind of like, you know, started messing around on my phone, you know, while watching this one right here. But on this Blu-ray, we get a making of featurette on here, you know, with the cast and crew talking about the making of the film. The actors are fine, it's just, I just really couldn't get into it. I was really trying though. And next up over here is from Dread Central Presents, and this is part of their, Dread Central Presents line, you know, the ones that put out Director's Cut, the Kane Hodder documentary and stuff. And this is their new one called Dry Blood that just got released today, which you guys can get from DreadCentralPresents.com or EpicPictures.com. And this is pretty much about this one guy who's an addict, you know, a drug addict. He's always, like, you know, shooting up or, you know, taking drugs so he can forget about, you know, his problems. And at the beginning of his film, he kind of just moves to his old house that he has in the middle of the woods. You know what I mean? Not the middle of the woods, but, like, pretty much in the middle of nowhere, like a small town, just to get away to see if he can, you know, get better. And yet he moves into this, he goes into this house that he owns, and he starts witnessing things that he thinks may be drug-related, but he's not 100% sure. He thinks he might see a ghost that may be haunting him at this house, but he thinks it may be because all the drugs that he's taken, but he's not exactly sure what's going on. There's a cop in this small town that's always on his ass for apparently no reason. And it's just a really well done kind of like psychological thriller film, and I kind of enjoyed it, you know, for what this one was. It also stars a friend of mine, Rob Galazzo. He plays like the local merchant at the local, like, you know, gas station / you know, like 7-Eleven kind of store. And he's there, like, always seeing this, you know, drug addict guy come in the store, like, breaking things, messing up things. And he's kind of like, dude, what the hell, bro? I really liked his performance in here. You get an audio commentary track by the director, making of special featurette, and some trailers on here. But if you're like weird, spooky, you know, things, if you don't know if it's like a ghost or if it's your mind playing tricks on you kind of movies, I think you guys will like this one right here, put out by Epic Pictures. And next up over here is a movie I've had on Blu-ray for a couple of weeks now, but I finally got around to watching it. Because I just want to throw up a review talking about it if I didn't actually sit there and watch it. But it is a movie that I've seen back in the day on VHS, and it's a film that's directed by William Lustig and stars what's his name again, Joe Spinell. And it's a new 3-disc edition, limited edition of Maniac here, put out by Blue Underground. It comes with a cool lenticular cover right here, and it's pretty much about Joe Spinell's character, who's a serial killer. He's completely out of his mind. He goes around killing, you know, just random women and random people, you know, on the streets of New York. Just why? For the hell of it, because he's nuts. And when he goes home to his house, he has, like, you know, these mannequin dolls, and he pretends like they're real, and that they're his friends, or that they're his lovers, and things like that. But yet he has a dark childhood past of, you know, of abuse, you know, in his past. And then in this film, he becomes infatuated with this, you know, female photographer, and things get turned really weird. This movie is actually really, really well done for an 80s, you know, slasher flick. And of course, you get the amazing special effects makeup, you know, effects made by Tom Savini, who also has a small supporting role, you know, in this film right here. You know, the same guy that made the special effects for Dawn of the Dead, you know, Night of the Living Dead, and stuff like that. The remake, of course. And this film actually looks a lot better on this new transfer right here, because we get a new 4K. Restoration of the film on here, and along with a whole bunch of special features like new commentary by William Lustig and the producer. We also get a lot of the old special features that were on previous editions of this film, like the Joe Spinell story with, like, family, friends, filmmakers talking about the actor that was in, like, you know, Goodfellas, and what was the other film? Rocky, and some other cool stuff from, like, the 70s, 80s, and things. I believe Joe Spinell died in the late 80s, if I'm not mistaken. But if you guys have never seen Maniac Cop, you pretty much watch this movie for Joe Spinell's performance, the maniac himself, and to watch all the cool, like, gore effects that, you know, that Tom Savini created back in this time. Really well done, man. But that's from Blue Underground, right here, a bunch of new special features. But if you're a fan of this film, just want to let you guys all know there's a 3-disc edition of it out that includes a motion picture soundtrack in here. So cool. And next up over here from Lionsgate Home Entertainment is a movie that came out last week on Blu-ray and 4K, and I just got my review copy in a few days ago from Lionsgate. And that is a movie I kind of wanted to see because a lot of my friends were talking about it, good-wise and bad-wise. And it's from the producer, one or two of the producers of While the Walking Dead, and it's Hellfest. This one right here takes place at a traveling haunted, haunted house attraction, and people go there every year. They set up and monsters come out and scare you. They have different mazes, of course. And it's about this this group of 20 somethings or whatever, or teens that go in there, but yet they don't know that there's a real psychopath on the loose. Can I speak right? On the loose, and killing people. But people don't really know if it's part of the show or not because, it's a haunted house attraction. And this small group starts getting picked off one by one. You have to watch the film to see how it all unfolds. And it also has a little cameo in here by Tony Todd, Candyman himself, up in this piece. I wasn't scared by this film at all. It didn't affect me as much as I thought I wanted it to. I wanted to care about the characters and when they died. And it was sort of like, kill them, who gives a shit, kind of movie. You don't really care about the characters very much at all. Of course, a lot of stupid things happen that get them killed, like they do in these films. It was kind of generic in a way. There really wasn't anything super creative other than, being at a haunted carnival. That was kind of a cool, playground they could have played with a lot more in this film. But the kills were kind of weak. In my opinion, I just expected a lot more from the premise of this film than they really did execute in here. The acting was just whatever. It didn't really do it for me, if you know what I'm saying. It wasn't horrible. It wasn't great. It was just sort of like I watched it once and I think I'm good. I think it's just one of those kind of movies, in my opinion now. But the last one right here I got from Universal Home Entertainment, and that is First Man, here on 4K, starring Ryan Gosling. And it's pretty much about, what's it called, Neil Armstrong, if I'm not mistaken now. And how him and his family were getting ready for him to, go up into space and to walk on the moon and everything like that. But this film, it wasn't exactly what I thought it was going to be. I thought it was going to be kind of like Apollo 13 or Armageddon, kind of sort of movie with some cool, really dope special effects, all throughout it or something. But it deals with more about, Ryan Gosling and his family and the before, going up in the space part. The trials and tribulations that go on in family dynamics and things. Don't get me wrong, the whole thing with the spaceship going up and doing all that looked dope, was sick as hell. But just the leading up to that part, I was kind of sort of bored by it. Decent performances and nicely directed, but I was just kind of bored by it. It didn't really do it for me. It does look amazing here on 4K. And it does have some really good special features on here, of course, behind the scenes, making of, deleted scenes, and all that mumbo jumbo that you used to for releases like this. But you let me know down below, what do you guys think about First Man? Did you guys see it in theaters, or are you guys buying this on a Blu-ray or 4K out there? Let me know down below in the comments. But guys, that's all I have to show and talk to you guys about today for this Hoarding Up video. Give this video a thumbs up. Drop a comment down below letting me know if you guys picked up Halloween or if you guys watched any of these movies I talked about today. And I'll see you guys all for the next adventure.